Hey guys, I'm coming to you today with another Amazon fashion review, and this time I have a lot of Daily Ritual, which is Amazon's own brand, and then I have a couple other brands, including one very popular designer dupe that you will want to stick around until the end to see. So I'm going to start with these Daily Ritual V-neck t-shirts. Let me just read you the exact name of them. They are the Daily Ritual Lived-In Cotton Slub Short Sleeve V-neck t-shirt, and I got them in the colors Charcoal Heather and Indigo Heather. I will say it's showing up really bright on this camera, and it also was really bright looking on the website, but in real life it doesn't seem as bright of a blue as I was expecting. It's kind of almost the same color as my denim jeans, so it's sort of annoying because I don't want to wear it with like exactly the same colored pants and just look like I'm wearing a single color, but just something to keep in mind when you're ordering them. So I actually went up a size. Amazon recommended that I wear a medium, and I ordered a medium at first and they were way too tight. I was looking for something just a little bit looser and less fitted, and the medium like just fit. So I returned them, exchanged them for a large, and a large fits perfectly. It's exactly what I was looking for. I just wanted a plain, loose fitting V-neck t-shirt, and that's exactly what this is. So it's a great basic item. They're currently $12 on Amazon, and again, I just went up one size from what Amazon recommended for me. So next we have the Daily Ritual Jersey short sleeve shirt, and I got two. I'm actually wearing one in black, and then I also have the light heather gray. So this is a little bit different style of shirt, and you'll see it more when you see the video of me wearing it. But it's it's very loose, super, super soft material, kind of thin. It has a boat neck, and then it's one of these shirts where there's not a shoulder seam. Actually, maybe I can show you better on the lighter color. There's no shoulder seam. There's just a straight seam coming down the shoulder. So there's just one seam coming straight down here, which gives it kind of like a flowier feel. So I really like it because I feel like, especially with a black one or like a solid colored one, it's really easy to dress up or down. It's obviously very comfortable. It's again, soft, light, loose, but you know, you can throw on a nice pair of earrings and wear it out to dinner like I just did while we were on vacation. I actually took both of these with me on vacation, and they were perfect to wear with shorts, jeans, capris, dress up, dress down. So they were really great. One thing that I was a little concerned about from some of the reviews is people were saying it's like really tight around the waist and it can be unflattering around the waist. I actually had the opposite opinion. So I feel like the waist of the shirt, or the bottom hem, is sort of the width that you would expect it to be, and the rest of the shirt is a little looser. It might be because, again, I sized up one from what Amazon recommended to me, and I feel like this is the right size for me. So, you know, that means that the waist or the bottom hem fits correctly, and then the rest of it is a little looser and drapier. So I feel like it kind of camouflages a tummy area more, but other people were saying that it's too tight in that area and it's not as flattering. So maybe try sizing up one with this style as well. So again, I did size up to a large, and these were $14.50 each. So next is this black hoodie. I'm going to read the name again to make sure I get it all right. It's the Daily Ritual Terry Cotton and Modal Full Zip Hooded Sweatshirt. So I got it in black, obviously, and it was a little bit pricey at $30.50 currently. I did go up one size from what Amazon recommended for me, from a medium to a large, and I know that it's a little bit for just a plain black hoodie. Number one, I was in the Daily Ritual mood, so I just bought a bunch of Daily Ritual stuff, but it really is very, very nice. Again, really soft material. It's kind of like a nice medium weight. I have another hoodie that I got on Amazon. It's Hanes brand, and it's more like the weight of a heavy t-shirt. So this is heavier than that, but it's not as heavy as like a regular fleecy hoodie that you usually get places. So it's kind of in between. It was perfect. Again, I took it on vacation. It was great for like being on the boardwalk at the beach at night when it got a little bit chillier. Really nice material. The zipper works great, and I'm very happy to have this in my collection. Again, I don't have, surprisingly, a lot of just black like top layers, so I think I'll get a lot of good use out of this season. So moving on to something that is not the Daily Ritual brand. This is a long color block cardigan. It is the Lovaru Women's Boho Open Front Cardigan, long sleeve, loose knit, lightweight sweater. And the style that I got is Z, letter Z, dark gray. So I actually found this through somebody else's video of Amazon clothes, or maybe it was like Amazon dupes of other styles, and they had linked to a different sweater in this listing, but I really like this style a lot more. It's just totally open front, no buttons or anything, no pockets, and I was actually super surprised when it came because I really thought it was going to be some cheap, you know, scratchy, light material. No, this is so nice. It's super soft. It's a lot heavier than I expected. Now, it could also be because it's like this giant sweater, so it's probably just heavier in general because it's more material, but it was just so much nicer than I expected. The colors are great. I don't usually wear like whites or creams, but I guess when it's blocked between two shades of gray, I will allow it. I did take a little time to read all the size charts and figure out which size would be best for me based on like the comments and the length. I was mostly concerned with the length. So I got a size large, which according to the size chart should be my size, and it is. So it actually hits me right at my knee. I'm like a little over 5'4", and it's right at the knee, which I think is where you want the style of sweater to be. I would have also been happy if it was a little shorter on me. So if you are taller than 5'4" and it recommends you a large, I think that will still look fine, but that's where it hits on me, just for reference. And this one was $31.88, which I think is a great deal for this kind of quality of a sweater. Again, it's like very on trend for this season. This is the type of style that you were probably seeing a lot of people picking up in the Nordstrom anniversary sale earlier in the fall. So I haven't worn this one yet. This is the one item that I haven't used yet in this video, but I am looking forward to it with leggings or skinny jeans or boots. I think it'll be really great for the fall season. So now we're getting into just a couple accessories. This first one is also an item that I just took with me on the vacation that I was just on. And this is the Timoy small travel jewelry case. So if you have seen some of my packing videos, you might have seen a different jewelry case that I have been using for several years. And it's kind of a hard-sided rectangle, a little bit taller than this. And I was just looking for something that was like a little flatter that I could maybe easily squish into like small spaces in a suitcase. I don't really need that much space. Primarily what I take and wear is earrings, and I might take like one necklace, and I also wanted a safe place to keep my rings at night. So this actually turned out to be perfect. I got it in the gray color, obviously, but when you open it up, it's just one space. There is this drawstring bag area in the middle, which you can keep things in, I guess, this little pouch. This side is meant to hold necklaces, or you could have put bracelets or something on here. So each of these little tabs kind of snaps open, and you can loop the necklace through there. They are magnetic snaps, all the snaps in this thing, which is really nice because even if you don't click it exactly, it kind of closes itself. So you thread the chain of the necklace through one of these snap tabs, and then the rest of the necklace is meant to kind of sit in this pouch. I did see some reviews where people said, oh, the necklaces get all tangled up anyway, and I could see that happening if they're all just together in this pouch, so take that with a grain of salt. Like I said, I don't really travel with like a ton of necklaces, so that's fine with me. The side that I am more concerned with and that I used extensively while on vacation is this side. So it has two kind of magnetic straps. So this one is a padded ring bar. So there's like a little foam in here. It snaps open and shut, and so you can store your rings on here. So either, you know, different rings that you're traveling with, or like for me, I just keep my wedding band on here at night just so I know where it is. So that's very convenient. And then this other tab has holes for earrings. So you can put, let's see, there's 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14 holes in here. Now I wear like bigger kind of dangly earrings, but you could put easily 14 little studs on here, seven pairs, or you know, a few pairs of bigger earrings here. So I had like three different pairs of large earrings with me on vacation, and they filled up this space pretty well. And again, the magnet just holds them in place. And so you just put the posts through the holes and magnet it shut. So that was perfect for traveling with. And this also really surprised me with its quality. It's not heavy, but it's like a good quality, kind of substantial feeling. The zipper works really nicely, and it's just a nice size and nice to have if you just want to travel with a couple pieces of jewelry. Maybe you're taking a short trip. And finally, this is the one that you probably have been waiting for. This is the Daisy Rose checkered tote shoulder bag. So it might look similar to another designer brand that you might be familiar with. It is not purporting to be that brand. And actually, the reason why I got this is because I have been thinking about getting something from that designer brand. But as you may know, I really don't wear browns or tans. I pretty much just do black and gray, and they don't really have anything in their classic style here that comes in black. So I got this one because I loved the fact that it was a black and gray checker print. So it doesn't have any logos, it's simply a checkerboard print. So it's currently $49.78 on Amazon. It does also come in a brown color palette and a cream color palette if you do want more of that classic look from that designer brand. So it's a little pricey, again, at almost $50, but I think it's totally worth it. I have gotten more comments and compliments on this purse than I have on probably any other bag I have ever carried. And usually it's people asking, like, is that because I didn't think it came in black? And no, it does not. And that is why I got this one. So I'll insert some footage of me wearing it so you kind of get a sense of the size. I believe it's the equivalent to like the MM size, the medium size of the designer tote. It's a little on the big side for me. I do like a large purse, and this is probably like the maximum size purse that I would wear. So quality-wise, it's really nice. I have been carrying it for the last couple weeks since I got it, and I'm not delicate with it at all. I'm like cramming it in my desk drawer, and you know, I don't like throw it around, but I'm not extra cautious with it. And it's holding up just fine. You can see the bottom. The one thing that I wish, and I don't know if the real version has this or not, but I do wish it had some little metal feet on it. But I had seen some people's reviews saying like, oh, I carried it for a couple weeks and it's totally cracked open, and I am not seeing that happening at all. It came really, really nicely packed. There's lots of like foam pieces and different things that would prevent it from coming out creased. The one thing that I did notice with it is just right here on the strap, you can kind of see it. There's a piece where the edge of the strap is kind of cracking. I think it actually came that way out of the package and I didn't notice it for a day or two. And it's sort of where it was bent, so it's probably from how it was packed in transit. It was maybe like where it folded over the top like this. And really, it's totally unnoticeable. If it does bother me, I could just cover over it with like some black Sharpie and I think that would be fine. Otherwise, the rest of the edges of the straps are totally intact. And it does come with a little pouch inside, which again is part of the real version, I think. The zipper on this is very nice as well, and it clips inside, or you can remove it and use it by itself. Inside it has a zipper pocket on one side and two pouch pockets on the other side. You can't see because it's black on black, but trust me. And there's no zip top, just like the real version, but it does have this little clip that you can clip together to kind of hold it in place. And it also has the little straps on either end that are supposed to be you know, for like adjusting it, which I don't think I would really do that. To me, they're more for aesthetic reasons. And then actually my mom saw it and she liked it so much she got one for herself. Ended up being from a different brand and a different style. But while we were talking, she asked me about some of the other Daisy Rose accessories. I mentioned this wallet. So she actually got me this wallet for my birthday. So I didn't write down the name of it because it wasn't actually my Amazon purchase. But if you're looking at some of the other Daisy Rose accessories, these are so nice. I still have the foam in here, but this has a bajillion card slots and the zippers are really nice. And then the cool feature that I liked about this one is it has this little strap on the back that you can kind of pull open, and then that gives you a little handle to carry it as a clutch. So I just thought that was neat. So I haven't used the wallet yet, but I have definitely been extensively carrying the purse and it's been holding up just fine. So I hope you enjoyed all that. If you did, please give me a thumbs up. If you like these sorts of videos, please subscribe because I do these a lot. I have a big time Amazon and online shopping problem. And go ahead and leave me a comment. Let me know which of these items did you like. Are you considering purchasing one of them? Is there something else that you've seen on Amazon that looks interesting? Maybe I'll check it out. So I'd love to hear what you have to say, and I'll see you next time. Bye.